Ridiculously cheap wrecking yard fines. Well, there's another way to get a classic Mercedes besides shopping on Craigslist, and that involves going to the wrecking yard. I bought some great Mercedes out of the junkyards in Central Florida, including my mom's 83 300 CD that she drove for 6 years before we decided to sell it, a 74 240D that hung around here for a really long time and provided good transportation for a customer of mine that was really off his rocker, and my girlfriend's 1987 190E 2.3, which was about to go to the wrecking yard before it got rescued by my friend Thomas, who told us about the car and we were able to get our hands on it. So today we have another wrecking yard find coming in a little bit later, and it's actually a very nice car. It's a 93 300E 3.2. So it's a pre-facelift 124 with the M104 twin cam motor. And when I was at the wrecking yard today, I saw a guy pulling this thing up in a truck, and I was like, how much? And he's like, $560. And I was like, does it run? And he goes, yeah. You know, people just don't appreciate stuff anymore. And 230,000 mile car, but it had no rust. It didn't have any horrible, nasty accident damage. It was an attractive color. It was black on gray, which I think is sexy. So I guess if you're considering looking for a classic Mercedes, you might just want to go to the wrecking yard because you might find some good stuff there. I remember my friend Steve bought an 85 300D out of the wrecking yard that I paid $350 for, and he drove that car as his regular transportation for the next 4 years. So, you know, people, we just live in a throwaway society where people discard stuff because they don't know what to do with it because they're too dumb to figure it out. So, you know, it's a good way to get into a pretty good car. And actually, my girlfriend's car has been a good car to the point where she's been able to drive it, you know, 200-300 miles a day for work, which says a lot considering that most really nice 190s don't even seem to be in 200-300 mile a day condition. Anyway, if you'd like some help, if you'd like to help us rescuing some of these Mercedes that are really not that expensive, drop us a line and we will try to, we can always hook you up with a Mercedes that's below $1,000 that needs a lot of help, but is generally a pretty solid car. I'd love some help finding home for these things, like this 85 right-hand drive 280SE. Be a nice car to put back in someone's garage. And other interesting cars. So thanks for wanting to participate, and take good care of your Mercedes so it doesn't end up in the wrecking yard and I don't have to buy it off of the back of a tow truck.